Sabi ni Ace, do you think the Senate has enough numbers to acquit VP Sara? You know what? I think we shouldn't let it reach that. I agree that you have to be counting and that it's necessary to count. But for me, even before, pagka nag-umpisa na yung sa House pa lang, pagka pinansin nila yung ano, yung complaint for impeachment, pagka nag-refer ang good governance sa Committee on Justice, dun pa lang, nasa kalye na ako. Bahala na kahit nag-iisa ako. Now, balik tayo. Okay, I got a clearer picture now at wala naman pong live ngayon. So, ang pasabog ng Kongreso, the Committee on Good Governance, decided to hold another hearing on the Vice President. Ang basis ng Committee on Good Governance to justify her budget. Okay, so maliwanag na. But the justification of her budget was made in writing. Ilinawin lang yung legal ha, because some of these things, they did not appear or were not mentioned during the ano, during any of the hearings. So hindi siya nag-appear to answer allegations on her budget. Ngayon, the problem with the congressman is this, that their duty is to allocate, right? And in doing so, they can conduct inquiries in aid of legislation. Ngayon, meron din tinatawag na oversight functions ang Congress. So, pursuant to their oversight functions, nag-hold sila ng inquiry. I think the original intention was kalkalin uli or pa rin tuloy-tuloy yung pagkakalkal sa confidential funds. Kasi yung confidential funds nga, as far as they know, they were able to procure or they were able to get copies of the notices of disallowances. Now, the problem with notices of disallowances are their lack of finality because may recourse pa to the courts in order to determine whether or not that notice of disallowance is correctly issued or the assessment is correctly made. Now, in a case for grave abuse of discretion, pwede niyong i-question yung decision ng COA as to whether or not it was attended with grave abuse of discretion and therefore mali yung decision na yun. So, it doesn't automatically result in a criminal case. Now, in the grounds for impeachment require that the crimes being accused of the public official are of the level of high crimes or actual graft and corruption. Okay? So, huwag nyo naman akong utusan magbasa, nagle-lecture na eh. Sabi ni Edzea, I saw there were cases filed with graft, ganyan-ganyan. Can you look at that news? Natignan ko na po. Pero huwag niyo naman akong uutusan pag nagle-lecture na. Okay? Pwede naman later. Pwede niyo naman padala yung link tapos babasahin ko yon. Pero actually, nabasa ko na yon. So, okay. So, tignan niyo yung progression. Okay? It starts with the budget. O, bakit yung budget ang ginamit nila? Because ang punta nila is doon sa pag-file ng graft. Okay? Yun ang gusto nilang puntahan. Nasaan yung charger? Ng itong camera. Wala kasi. So, yun ang hinahanap nila. What they were doing was fishing. So, it started with the confidential funds. Pero dahil ang confidential funds, hindi pa final yung mga notices of disallowances, hindi aabot dun sa level ng high crimes. Okay, so next, hanap sila. Pag graft and corruption, kailangan in order for it to be a high crime, dapat ang penalty ay umaabot dun sa capital punishment, which means kailangan plunder. Okay. So, wag muna yung interruptions naman kung ano. You can add details. Okay. Wag all caps. Wag nyo akong iyo all caps. Hindi ko babasahin yan. Okay. Alright. So, para umabot sa level ng high crimes, naghanap sila ngayon ng whistleblower. Now, itong problema nila with the whistleblower is disgruntled employee. And therefore, you can question the motives of this person in coming forward now. In fact, if this were a court hearing, then it can be, the defense can raise the issue that there is no actual crime. She's exaggerating it because she wants to get even. Okay. So, automatically, meron na kaagad na defense ang Office of the Vice President. My guess is that they were anticipating this. Now, the whistleblower apparently is an undersecretary or assistant secretary at the Department of Education, notorious already because she had previous cases when she was formerly with the Development Academy of the Philippines, sa DAP. Ngayon, dito sa DAP, merong mga charges filed against her and hindi pa malinaw if she has been exonerated for that. Kasi pag hindi pa final yung iyong judgment and wala kang administrative dismissal, you can actually still continue public office. Now, my presumption is that either it's with a higher court or it has already been dismissed. Not surprisingly, however, she was discovered by the OVP, officials of the Department of Education of soliciting, most likely soliciting from suppliers or contractors, and possibly obtained the amount of 16 million, which is backed up by documentary evidence. Now, why is it important, documentary evidence? Because it's harder to lie, okay? However, the documentary evidence, in order to be accepted by the court, will require attestation by a person, the person who created it, the person who received it, the person who authenticated it, etc. Okay. Si VP Sara, sabi ni Way, I see it, si VP Sara mismo nag-fire sa kanya loss of trust and confidence ng second DepEd. Yes, actually, kasi pag nasa level ka na ng higher management, ASEC, USEC, etc., it is the secretary talaga who will fire you because you are the boss. Pwede kasi pag sa rank and file, it will be their supervisors or their managers and it will be, concurred in by the secretary. So talaga naman SEC yung gagawa noon. Hindi yung there's nothing special about that. The SEC really is the one who signs that. Unless, higher level, the appointing authority will do that. So it will depend kung sino yung appointing authority. If it is the secretary who made the appointment, then the secretary gets the right to hire and fire. Okay. So, sabi ni Dan, sa comment section ng GMA, tuwang-tuwa yung mga engot na anti-Duterte. Yun lang pinakinggan nila, pero yung side ni VP sa live, di ata napanood. Maengot talaga, going bananas agad. Now, no, the reason they are nagditiwang sila is because it will not depend on whether or not in a criminal case, exonerated siya. It's not about that. It's not even about evidence. It is about how the Congress will appreciate it. Why? If this is an impeachment case, it will be Congress who will determine if this is sufficient cause for impeachment. So, you understand now bakit may ganun na clause. Okay. So, I'm not saying that this is going to fly. What I am saying is that what is important is that we, the people, can appreciate the evidence and can appreciate that this is clearly an operation, machinations against the vice president. Ulit. Bakit sinasabing nasabota? Hindi naman ako nawala. Okay, ulit. Do not be too sure about yung mga sinasabi ng kabila or yung sinasabi natin. Because Congress will be the one to appreciate it. Tingnan nyo halimbawa, ang nangyayari dito kina Alice Go. Sa totoo lang, these are matters that are best left to the courts. But tuloy-tuloy-tuloy ng Senado yan. What is their purpose? Para sa akin, twofold. If the rumors are true, well then, of course, it's obvious that the Dutertes are the ultimate targets. They want her to attest, again, to testify against the Dutertes. That's another. And number three is for them to get their hands on her wealth, on her assets. Mayaman ito, gurgurin natin, threaten her with jail, magsusuka yan ng whatever, she'll give it up to them para lang makaligtas. Okay? In short, it's a, ano bang tawag doon? Hindi con eh. Yung parang blackmail. Organized blackmail. So, what do we do? First, based on our own appreciation, tignan natin yung ebidensya. Para sa atin, maliwanag yan. Nakahanap sila ng isang disgruntled para manira. Pero if the documentary evidence indicates that this person was dismissed for cause, then it will go against her now. It can controvert, it can help controvert what she's saying. Oh, extortion. Thank you, Doc Edelay. Okay. Ulit. So now, what do we do? It is ultimately a political solution because an impeachment proceeding is a political event. It is a political proceeding. In other words, the evidence and the the arguments that are going to be made there only serve the purpose of whoever is in the majority. Right. So if it serves their purpose, then it's how that's how they're going to appreciate it. Remember what happened to Justice Corona. Yung evidence na ginamit kay Justice Corona would never stand up in any court. Not even the kangarooest of the kangaroo courts. The monkeyest of monkey trials. Kumbaga, hindi yan titindi. But because Congress is not really a court, the evidence will be based on their appreciation. Which means it is more important for us now to defend the Vice President. Why? The congressmen and the senators, they are there and they cast their votes as our representatives. Ibig sabihin, yeah, yung mga boto nila, dapat nire-reflect yung pagka-representante nila. Dahil kinakatawan nila na sila ay kumakatawan sa atin. And therefore, if the vote is unpopular, we can demand that they vote in accordance with the standards that we set. Yung standards natin, nating mga mamamayan. Kung sa tingin natin, ang nipis ng ebidensya na ito, halatang ginugurguro nyo lang, halatang pinahihirapan nyo lang, at halatang may political intent behind all of these things. So, we need to be strong about our opinions on this one. On these things. Uy, say hi naman, nandito si Doc Ethel. So, sabi ni Wei, I see it documented yung mga offenses ni Gloria Mercado, kaya mahihirapan silang ipakagat yung mga allegations niya against VP Sara. Correct. And that is something that we must also strongly advocate for. Yun, pwede po bukas. Sana wag maulitin kay Justice Corona kay VP Sara. I don't think it will. You know why? Because si Justice Corona was constrained by the fact that mahistrado siya ng Korte Suprema. Mayroong particular behavior ang mga judges and justices. Hindi sila nga pwede pa-eval, di sila pwede magpa... But VP Sara, no. She's with the executive and therefore iba yung mga pamamaraan na pwede niyang gamitin. Sabi ni Ma'am Helen, makikinig pa kaya ang mga representatives sa atin? Well, not if you're nega. Diba? It can be scary for them pag nakita nila na tayo lang. That's why importante sa kanila yung mga trolls nila. That's why nagha-hire na rin sila ng mga trolls na mga dating DDS para sa para atakihin ang mga DDS. Katulad niyan, yung kaninang pumasok dito sa live. Ano yung purpose? Manggulo. At guluhin or mawala ng credibility yung mga influencers or yung mga nag-explain. Sabi ni Marlon, this government is really desperate. It's becoming comical. Thanks for enlightening us. Sassy Fierce says, what will happen if ever lang ma-impeach si VP Sara? Of course, magrarally yung mga tao and then mapilitan si BBM na bumaba sa pwesto. Will be the next president? I really hope it's not Tammy. Well, wag natin paabutin dun sa punto na may na-impeach. But wait, let's be precise. Ano yung term na impeachment? Impeachment isn't yung pagtanggal. Impeachment is when the Congress decides that she will go to trial. That's what impeachment is. Pagka natanggal ka, yun yung removal mo. Impeachment trial yung nangyayari po sa Senate. But actually, the term impeachment trial isn't correct. It is a trial, but not an impeachment one. Because impeachment, guys, what happens in Congress. Maria says, pwede pang kasuhan ni VP si Mercado given VP's paper trail evidence? Kung perjury, pwede po. Sabi ni Dang, salamat po kung ganon. Kasi grabe ang dumi lumaro ng administration. Garapan. Totoo. Melton says, ma'am, saka tinanong yung Yusef ng isang kongresista kung dala yung envelope na sinasabi niya, ang sagot niya ay hindi. Pero nung nalaman na nag-press con si VP Sara, ay biglang tinapas yung envelope. I know. Ano yung value ng envelope na yun? Unless nakasulat doon from Inday Sara. Diba? Ano yung value nun? May malilift pa ba na fingerprints yan? Wala na po yung chain of evidence niya. At totoo lang, well, even if may laman yung mga ano na yan, proving that those envelopes and that money came from VP Inda is another thing altogether. The object evidence, money and the envelopes do not per se link her to VP Inday. John Michael says, with what is going on in the HOR now, it seems like they're having a mock impeachment with all those envelopes and all. Seems like a very familiar scenario. Totoo. Sabi ni Robert, si Tingog kanina pumasok lang pag-mention ng envelope. Sabi ni Robert, ipapa-autopsy nila yung supre. Sabi ni Kat-Kat, probably you're not meant to be sec-fixy but rather sent-fixy. Sige, convince niyo pa ako. Isang tao lang makakonvince sa akin. Bet she'll say this. Isang tao lang makakonvince sa akin. Ito si Kat-Kat to. Wait, Colagong says, watch the VP in thy live press briefing. Napakagaling niya mag-respond. Very professional in a way to avoid the mentioned people, not to be stepped on without their consent. Kuya Well says, the purpose is to take down the popularity of the Dutertes. This is clearly said by VP Sara. Sabi ni CRTB, while Mercado is explaining to very obvious she's inventing her stories, putol-putol lang sagot niya at halatang nag-iisip kung anong sasabihin. Sabi ni Sasi, grabe yung pag-build up ng character ni Mercado kanina. Akala ko kakampi na ni VP Sara eh, kaya pala mapait si Luis to sa kanya. Eh, yung pala, ipipilit yung robbery. Hala. Neneng Navarro says, after yan, bibigay ulit ng Congress sa kanya kasi lagay nila kay Gloria yon. Norvin said, parang Arab style, open the envelope, dami kadramahan ng HOR, kawatan naman sila. Inis ako kanina kay Dam Fernandez, na high blood ako. Alam nyo, kasi maikli na talaga pasensya ko kakapanood sa kanila. Because they violate so many rules, their own house rules, they violate the rules of court, they violate the rules of evidence, they violate grammatical rules. Kakaloka, parang ato to, anong mundo kayo nakatira? Marianne Ferreira says, this admin is the worst in this lifetime, parang in-unleash ni Marcos yung lahat ng demonyo. Sabi ni Alter Ginto, thanks po na hindi kayo bayaran. Simpleng mamamayan lang kami, pero mulat na kami sa baho ng BBM admin. Ay na. Thank you po. Pero yun na nga lang, expect nyo po na definitely may magdodol. Meron na naman mag-aano dyan, meron magsasabi na. Yun na nga, di ba yung kanina, wow, spy daw sa PDP laban. Hello, I'm not even with PDP and I'm not running for Senate. So, good luck with that theory. Sabi ni Ma'am Josephine, nanood ako konti sa Congress. Ako'y na high blood. Di ko tinapos. Buti good timing sa live nyo. Thank you po, attorney. Me too, dry cough. O ma'am, magpagaling kayo. Promise, papagaling ako kung kayo magpapagaling. Sean says, sa lahat po ng nangyayaring bruhaha, majority of the Filipinos believe in Inday and Tatay. Tayo nagpapasweldo sa kanilang mga kongresista, I assume. All those three branches of government, what can we do about this? This is so frustrating po. Like I said, it's going to have to be a political solution for now. And what is a political solution? The strength of our voice. The strength of our galit. Kaya nga ngayon, mas nagiging mahalaga yung nagpupulong-pulong tayo. Nagiging mahalaga po yung itong nagsasalita, nagpapahayag, yung buwisit natin, inabas natin one way or another, kailangan umabot sa kanila. Sabi ni Boracay Island, Philippines, it's about time na magsalita na tayo do actively commenting on social media. They're playing dirty politics sa pamamagitan ng paninirang puri, demolition, and demonizing VP Sara. 32 million tayo, mas marami. Mukhang panahon na rin na i-invade natin ang Twitter, ano, ang X. Lang choice eh. Sabi ni Dang, sarap sabihin kay Mercado, if you come to court, come to the court. Mali po. The adage is, if you come to a court of equity, you must come with clean hands. Cortez, family says, nabudol po tayong lahat, parang nabuksan natin lahat yung Pandora's box. I agree. Lahat ng bad energy lumabas. Tsaka yung mga bad elements, no? Jenny March says, too much na sila mambabastos. hindi pala mambabastos. Kahit pa sabihin na may immunity sila, dapat yan i-call out ng invited nila, sabihin, hoy, inquiring po ito, hindi ito husgado para bumalik sa kinalalag niya nila. Sabi ni Ray, why are the attack dogs of Tamba so brazen and powerful? Diyos ko, tinatanong mo ba yan? Pero tama kayo, brazen and powerful. Jordan says, what would happen if they railroad this impeachment like what Manny Villar did during Arab's time, given that Villanes said they have like 18 senators in their fold? May magagawa ba? What I don't understand is why you doubt. Why do you doubt na may magagawa? We've done it before. That's what they're forcing us to do. And the reason I think that they're doing being so brazen and powerful nga, as they're saying, is because they doubt our ability to be angry and take to the streets. Aabot po sa punto na ganun. The question now is, papayag pa ba kayo na ginagawa nila ito? Kasi kung hindi kayo pumapayag, taking to the streets will eventually become our only option. We have to speak out now para bigyan lang sila ng pagkakataon na pag sumabog ang galit namin, abay, wala na, pasensyahan tayo. Ni Ma'am Lynn, lahat po sana ng nabudol, maglabasan at i-aus na si Bangal. Be careful with your words. Pero tama yung term na sana. Sabi ni Richard, bakit ganun mga kongresista ngayon sa halip ng mga batas inaatupag, plus hearing na walang kalatoy-latoy na politics, actually walang kwenta. Sabi ni Ace, do you think the Senate has enough numbers to acquit VP Sara? You know what? I think we shouldn't let it reach that. I agree that you have to be counting and that it's necessary to count. But for me, even before, pagka nag-umpisa na yan sa House pa lang ha, pagka pinansin nila yung complaint for impeachment, pagka nag-refer ang good governance sa Committee on Justice, dun pa lang, nasa kalye na ako. Bahala na kahit nag-iisa ako. Sabi ni Paul, uy, grabe naman si Paul. Diyos mo yan, tumanda na sa servisyo, nagsisinungaling pa. Ang tanong nga, bakit andun pa siya? Paano niya nalulusutan yung mga kaso niya? Sabi ni Sky, mukhang mahihirapan mag-say ng no si attorney if si PRD na makiusap sa... Grabe. Sa totoo lang, kahit si Mayor Baste lang, pero okay. Way I see it, says, maski anong haba pasensya ko, di ko rin nakayanan tapusin yung QUADCOM hearing. Si Dan Fernandez, gusto pang turuan ng COA kung anong dapat maging decision sa audit ng CF ni VP. Hala, nasama na si VP sa QUADCOM? Ano ba? Usurpation yata ang gusto. Mababa ang penalty ng usurpation, ha? Kung ako yan. Diyos ko, ano bang motivation mo kong Dan, ha? Saan ka galing? Gandang hapon kay Leonardo. Bakit walang maisog arali ngayon? Ngayon, wala lang nakaschedule. Marami kasing leadership fora, hindi rally. RME says, non-stop at minamadali si VP at all cost. Parang hindi to tungkol sa 2028, but later anticipation regarding VP and mental health na baka bumigay. Posible. Maganda yung sinabi mong yan. Bakit sila nagmamadali? Because they'll change the constitution and iuupo nila because they're going to change the constitution. And they don't want anybody to be in a position to oppose. Now, huwag niyong kakalimutan yung hashtag. Kasi hindi na rin relevant yung hair follicle test at this point. Alam niyo kung ba? Hindi naman sa hindi relevant. Pwede pa rin. Pero, magpakalbo eh. That's wrong actually. Dapat kung mananawagan tayo, maniniwala dapat tayo na kaya natin i-check kung mandaya sila o hindi. But still, the issue of the president's mental state is correct. The issue of the president's health is correct. The issue of whether or not the president is still competent to be the president, to be the leader of the country is also correct. Not just because of his health, but because of the fact that everything is falling down all around us. That we have, the peso has devalued because we have chosen an importation policy. The economy is actually looking worse and worse than it is. Because if it were okay, if we were good, bakit nagbenta ng ginto? Ang sinasabi ng iba talaga namang healthy naman daw para magbenta and so on as long as there's X amount and so on. I'm not sure about that. In fact, when it comes to the economy, the one thing that we're sure of is the rising prices and the fact that the peso can no longer buy as much as it used to. Mataas na nga ang presyo, devalued pa yung peso. And hindi naman tumataas ang mga sweldo natin. Hindi naman tumataas ang capability natin to make money. And so what's going on? Prices are rising all around us. And yet, di ba? Sino lang ang yumayaman? Aba, puro mga barkada. Tapos may gana pa. May gana pang sabihan tayo na ano, naiinggit tayo sa mga concerts? Na ano tayo? Di ba? The way they slander us. The way they look down on people na hirap sa araw-araw. Pati yung mga insulto na, ano, gutom ka? Yung mga ganun, do they hear themselves? Do they understand what they're saying? Itong administration na to, they talk through their claws. And their claws are saying things like, oh, nakakahiya, nagugutom ka. Yung mga ganun, oh, nagutom ka pa ba? O kaya yung mga, ano, yung mga, ayaw nilang nakikibaka tayo. Parang pinagtatawa na nila yung galit natin na nagrarally tayo. Tapos pinagtatawa na nila yung ano, pati yung bakit daw tayo nakikialam sa pagbenta ng gold, di naman daw atin yung gold. Di mga ganyan. These polls reflect exactly what the administration is thinking. Na they even went through great lengths to, yung para pa kunwari na hindi tunay yung ano, yung video. And why are they impeaching the vice president? I will remind you. What happens when there is a vacancy in the office of the vice president? The president chooses who will be the vice president. And he chooses from the Senate or Congress or the House. Ivy says, inawalin na kay Pinay, kay Villar kasi malakas na maging presidente. Eh kay Sara, wala silang makita kaya nahirapan sila. Ash says, plano ma-impeach si VP pagdating sa Senado, magrarally ang kaliwa at pinklawan para ma-pressure ang Senado. Pupondohan niya ng mga oligarch at mga organisado sila di tulad ng mga Duterte supporters. So ano Ash, what do you want us to do? So ganyan kanega yung sasabihin mo. Okay, sige, fine. Let's say na totoo yan. What do you want? Do you have anything? Or are you saying, sige, humiga na lang tayo sa harap ng EDSA, magpasagasa na tayo kasi there's nothing we can do. Pero alam mo, hindi ako naniniwala na ganyan. Unang-una, hindi ganun kadali magparali yung kaliwa. Kailangan niya ng pera. So, sige, assume natin na bibigyan sila ni Tamba ng pera para mag-rally na mag-rally. So, tingin nyo, okay lang sa inyo yon, and that nobody will be driven by their anger? May mga nakakalimutan ka mga tao. Marvin says, HOR, gusto mo mag-apply sa COA, mas magaling pa sila mag-audit. Good point. Sabi ni Clara, huwag masyadong magpapaniwala kay Trililing. Lahat ng tinya trip kinakasuhan niya pero hanggang filing lang. Oh, tsaka kaliwat kanan ng talo niya, except for one. Tama ba yun? Ah, hindi. Tama ba yun yung kay ano? Ah, hindi. Except for, wala pa rin yata. Sino nang napanalo niya? May naipanalo na ba siya? Sabi ni Vicente, sasama kami sa kalye. Sasama, talaga, but wait ha. Intayin natin na kapag finorward ng House of Representatives ang complaint ng pag-finorward ng Committee on Good Government and complaint to the Committee on Justice, that is the time to move. Sabi ni Bayon. Bayon on. Pasalamat si Kimbo, di siya na-under kay VP dahil kung nagkataon matagal na ang 10 minuto na di siya palayas. Ama si Jason. Hindi lang si Bangag paalis yun, si Tamba. Nakakahiya na tayo, ginagawa na tayong tanga. Hmm. No, we don't. Jim says, we need to concentrate now on the issue of corruption. How can you concentrate on an issue of corruption when it happens so many areas? No, you can't. Okay? You can't concentrate in. Look, people don't have revolutions based on a single issue. In 1898, what were the issues? Dalawa yan. Secularization and polos y servicios. So you don't need to concentrate on one. You can have more than one. You can be angry about so many things. Look, in the Marcos Sr. administration, almost 20 years, 18 years in order to be able to oust him. Ano yung mga issues? Of course, there was corruption, but there were so many ones. Plus, yung ano, yung catalyst was the assassination. Yung human rights issue, that wasn't even what moved the people. It was the blatant images of profligate spending. Sabi ni Dan Clyde, I don't think napapayag ang military if i-push nila si Tamba, kapatid ni VP, in case totoong ang health deterioration ni PDM. It doesn't even have to be a health deterioration. My point here is that he's not fit to lead. He has no leadership. Para sa akin, if that's a medical issue, so be it. Kumbaga, no guts. yun ang medical issue niya, no guts to stand up to his wife, to the Speaker of the House, no guts to stand up to the oligarchs, no guts, period. No vision. There's something wrong with his eyes. He cannot take the country to the future because he cannot see that far. He can only see up to the next concert. That is my... Ano yung health issues ni Presidente? Poor eyesight because he has no vision for the country. No guts because he cannot stand up to the people who pressure him, like his wife, Speaker, and oligarchs. Ano pa? Diba? Ah, a skin condition. Kasi manhid na manhid sa panawagan ng taong bayan. Rob Chi says, it's obvious that the country is going down as they're using all resources, even the reserves. Yun na nga eh. So, what do they do? What are they going to do? They don't have, wala nang pera yung gobyerno. They need to bleed us more. So, what are they going to do? In the next, they don't want to be popular anymore. They don't care about the popularity, but they care about being leaders. And if they're leaders, if they are dictators, then they can just raise taxes. They can raise taxes, they can raise government fees, licensing fees, all of these fees. They can keep doing that and bleed us even more. Jim Abuel says, pinagtutulungan din nila si Marcoleta. Is there a way para matuloy ang gusto niya na maipatawag din sa House ang mga may disallowances? This is, okay. Alam mo, napapressure ako sa mga tanong ninyong ganyan. No, there's no way for us to do it. None for us. It's a matter for Congress. So that will be up to Congressman Marcoleta kung paano niya itutulak yan. But what I keep saying to people is that Congress is a collegial body, meaning the decisions are made by either the congressmen voting as a body or as a majority of the body, or a decision can be made by the speaker. So, parang lumalabas eh, ano ba, wala mong paraan? Parang ako yung binibigyan ninyo ng pressure to come up with a solution. I don't have a solution for problems that are within Congress. Kailangan yan, Congress ang sasagot.